Dear students, today we'll start about introduction of material. Basically, to start the topic electronics, we need to understand the first the topic of about materials. Like, as we know that this is nothing but we are going to study based on the electrical properties of material. As we know that the flow of electrons in any material is related to the electronics. So first of all, we'll see that what are the electrical properties, based on electrical properties, what are the types of materials, and then we'll go for the basic semiconductor and its applications. So here, based on its conductivity means where the electrons, means based on the current flow, conductor means conducting means conduct karna means it means that the flow of current, basically how much amount of current is flow, on the basis of that we are categorizing this one in three types: conductor, insulator and semiconductor. Okay, so let us see first conductor. So conductor is a material which has very high conductivity. That means it conducts, that means the flow of electrons, and that means electricity flow is highest in conductor. For example, why it is highest? Because the presence of electrons is very much large in case of conductor. For example, we can have some like gold, bronze, silver, mercury, copper, brass and etc. So these are the some examples of conductor which has highest amount of conductivity in kind of all kind of materials based on its electrical properties. Now we see insulator. As you know that insulator means insulating things. That means it doesn't allow to flow the current. It means it has very low level of conductivity because under pressure, or you can say at a absolute temperature, it has no free electrons. So if there is no free electrons, that means conduction of current will not take place. So that's why it is called insulator. Insulator means insulating things. That means it will insulate between two kind of things. That's why it is called insulator. So here, for example, of insulators are mica, rubber, wood, wool, paper and etc. So in this kind of material, there will be no flow of electricity. That means conductions will not take place. So in the case of conductor, highest conductivity. In case of insulator, no conductivity. Now we'll see the semiconductor. So therefore, semiconductor is a material that has conductivity level somewhere between extremes of insulator and conductor. That means not very low, not very high. It is the between the high and low. That means middle of conductor and insulator. So that's why it is called semiconductor. So here you can see semi means partial or half, conductor means it has property of conductor. So if it has partial property of conductor, that is called semiconductor. So semiconductor is nothing but a revolution in the field of electronics. So we'll mainly focus in the upcoming lectures on semiconductor. So here, conductor means it has highest conductivity, maximum number of electrons. Insulator means it has no conductivity, that means no free electrons. And semiconductor, it has conductivity between conductor and insulator. That means it is nothing but having middle, somewhere between conductor and insulator. Conductivity is in between conductor and insulator. So it is neither an insulator nor a conductor, but it is, that's why it is called semiconductor. Clear? So here we saw the differences of conductor, insulator and semiconductor based on conductivity. Here see some other property like resistivity. As we know that resistivity means resist, it is resisting something. That's why it is called resisting. Here resisting means it is resisting the flow of current. That's what is called resistivity, and it is nothing but opposite of the conduction. Okay, so which is low or negligible in the case of conductor. If you'll talk about resistivity just opposite to the conductivity. So because conductivity was highest in case of conductor, so in this case it will be lowest. And resistivity will be a very high insulator because conductivity was very less. And moderate means in between insulator and conductor, or resistivity will be in case of semiconductor. Similarly, if you'll go in terms of valence electrons, so there is only one valence electrons in outermost shell of the conductor. That means when you talk about conductor, so valence electrons, that means the outermost orbit. As you know that atoms has several orbits, so whatever the electrons will be present in the outermost orbit will be called valence electrons. Clear? So in case of conductor, there will be only one valence electron, whereas in case of semiconductor we have four number of valence electrons. That means outermost orbit have four electrons, as well as if you'll talk about insulator, it has eight number of valence electrons. Okay, so if you'll talk about in terms of valence electrons, that means outermost orbit electrons, because if you'll be having only one, it can be easily gets free, so that's why it has high conductivity. If it is full, that means eight, it is the highest number of valence electrons can be accumulated. So if it has eight electrons in outermost orbit, so there is no chances of getting any conduction. I mean getting conducted of with some other atoms. And when it has four, then it has chances to be getting conducted and also non-conducted. Okay, so that's why it is nothing but on the basis of valence electron, it is also have the same property like we have in based on conductivity. Now, if you'll talk about what kind of bonding that takes place. So conductors takes the metallic bonding. It has metallic bonding properties. Whereas semiconductor is nothing but it has covalent bonding properties, and insulator is nothing but having ionic bonding properties. So these are the properties of conductor, semiconductor, insulator, which we are discussing right now. This is the basics of electronics. Now we'll see here the value of conductivity. I'll go in short about this because already we have talked about conductivity and resistivity. So if you talk about value, approx value will be 10 to the power minus 7 mo per meter in case of conductor. Whereas if you'll go for semiconductor, it will be somewhere between 10 to the power minus 7 to 10 to the power minus 13, because it is nothing but in between the insulator and conductor, whereas the insulator have 10 to the power minus 13 mo per meter. That means approx negligible conductivity. That means minus power, it is in minus, so it is nothing but it is very very less. When it is 10 to the power minus 7, that means very high. Minus 7 to minus 13 between conductor and insulator, and it is 10 to the power minus 13 means negligible. Similarly, if you go for resistivity, conductor will have 10 to the power minus 5 ohm meter, whereas semiconductor will be having 10 to the power minus 5 to 10 to the power plus 10 to the power 5 ohm meter, and insulator is having more than 10 to the power 5 ohm meter. Here ohm meter means how much amount of resistivity in ohms per meter. Okay, each meter, I mean in 1 meter, it will have 10 to the power minus 5 ohm. Here 10 to the power minus 5 to 10 to the power plus 10 to the power 5, and in case of insulator it will be having 10 to the power 5. That is nothing but very very high. Now we'll talk important terms about forbidden energy gap. What is forbidden energy gap? Forbidden is gap, you can understand, gap is nothing but gap between two points, and forbidden means between two layers. Okay, so here the gap between the valence band and conduction band. What is valence band and what is conduction band? Already we talked about valence electrons. So the outermost orbit is called nothing but valence band, where the energy of outermost orbit electrons found in the valence band, and the conduction band is nothing but when the electrons gets free and it reaches to the conduction band. Okay, so the gap between the valence band and conduction band is nothing but called forbidden gap is not found in conductor. That means it is overlapping. There is no gap between valence and conduction band. That means whatever the electrons are present, those are some of the electrons are valence electrons and some of the electrons are conduction band electrons. So that's why there is a very easily they can conduct, while there is a small forbidden gap in semiconductor. But semiconductor will have a very less amount of forbidden energy gap. That means gap between valence band and conduction band. So if we can provide some energy, that easily it can reaches to the conduction band. And a large forbidden gap seen in the insulator. So it is very high gap between conduction band and valence band. So electrons will not pass from valence to conduction. So there will not be any flow of current. Clear? Now we'll see here the forbidden energy band diagram, because based on that it will be easily visualized that how the energy band diagrams will be differing of insulator, semiconductor and conductor. You can see here insulator, we are measuring in terms of electrons volt. This is nothing but energy. This is the valence electrons, valence band, and this is the conduction band. So you can see in case of insulator, it is the highest. That means greater than 5 electrons. And there is no electrons in the conduction band because you cannot get that much high amount of energy to get in electrons travel from valence to conduction band. Similarly, when you go for the semiconductor will have less amount of, there is a gap between semiconductor valence band and conduction band. As you know, that conduction band means the electrons free to establish conduction. That means nothing but free electrons are nothing called conduction, are in conduction band. So if we can see that conduction band have energy in electron volt, there are three kinds of semiconductor we have assumed: silicon, germanium and gallium arsenide. In case of silicon, it has 1.1 electron volt energy gap, 0.67 electron volt energy gap in case of germanium, and 1.4 approximately electron volt in case of gallium arsenide. So there is a small amount of gap between valence and conduction. So after getting some kind of energy, heat in terms of heat or in terms of applied voltage, it can easily get from valence band to conduction band, and conduction gets starts. Now we'll come for conductor. Conductor will have no gap. You can see this conduction band and valence band are overlapping each other. So there is no, that means zero electron volt gap between, there is no energy band gap between valence and conduction band. So this is nothing but band diagram. So from this band diagram, you can clearly understand that is how this band diagram or insulator, semiconductor and conductor varies in terms of their conductivity. So in this last slide, we'll see one very important property of semiconductor, that is called negative temperature coefficient. So as of now, what we understand about semiconductor, this first topic, a first unit of your basic electronics will be of semiconductor and its application. So you must understand what is semiconductor. To understand the semiconductor, what we have done, we have compared the semiconductor with conductor as well as with insulator, so that we got an idea that what is semiconductor. Now if we understand that semiconductor is a material whose conductivity is between insulator and conductor. So now if it is having, we have semiconductor and we have conductor, then why we need semiconductor? Because semiconductor is the material where we can control automatically and manually according to the requirement. That means the flow of electrons and flow of conductivity will be controlled. But where in the case of insulator and conductor, we cannot control it out. So that's why we are going and moving to the semiconductor. So here it has very good property that is called negative temperature coefficient. That means of resistance. That means the resistance of semiconductor decreases when we increase the temperature, or vice versa. That means at the high temperature, resistance will be low, and at low temperature, resistance will be high. For example, germanium is actually an insulator at low temperatures, but it becomes a good conductor at high temperature. Why it is so? Because at low temperature, it will have very high resistance. And when there will be high resistance, then there will be no current flow. So that's why it is nothing but it will behave like an insulator. Now, as the temperature rises from absolute zero Kelvin, absolute zero Kelvin means minus 273 degrees Celsius. Okay. So at zero Kelvin, an increasing number of valence electrons absorbs sufficient thermal energy to break the covalent bond, because as low temperature, minus 273 degrees Celsius, it will behave like an insulator. When we start increasing some temperature, what will happen? The electron, the valence or covalent bond between the electrons or between the two atoms, it will start breaking it out, because when you increase the temperature, the resistivity will start decreasing. So when we increase the temperature, what will happen? The thermal energy, it will absorb the sufficient amount of thermal energy to break the covalent bond. And when the covalent bond will be breaked, then the number of free electrons will be start getting increases. So as you know that the nothing but electrons, free electrons are the carrier of conductivity. So if this increased number of carriers or free electrons will increase the conductivity in case of high temperature means I start increasing some temperature of a semiconductor material. So what we come to know about semiconductor is initially at very low temperature is nothing but an insulator. When we provide some amount of temperature to it, then the covalent bonding between the atoms will start breaking it out and number of electrons will start generating. As you know that when there will be a number of electrons, then automatically the conductivity is nothing but start increases, because the flow of electrons is nothing but electrons is electricity. The new flow of electrons is nothing but electricity. So conductivity gets increased. So that's why we prefer semiconductor as compared to the conductor and insulator in case of electronics instruments, or you can say automatic control of electrons or electricity. Clear? So at last, I'll revise it out what we have studied in this lecture. We have talked about types of semiconductor material basically based on the electrical properties, and the base of electrical property we have divided into the three parts: insulator, conductor and semiconductor. So in case of insulator, we came to know that it has we talked about conductivity, that means flow of electrons. So conductivity is very, very, very less in case of insulator, that means negligible. In case of conductor, it is highest. In case of semiconductor, it is in between. Then we talked about resistivity. It is opposite to the conductivity. So resistivity is nothing but very high in case of insulator, very low in case of conductor, and in between, that middle of this both, is nothing but semiconductor. Similarly, we talked about bonding. Then metallic bonding will take place in case of conductor. In case of semiconductor, will have covalent bonding, and in case of insulator, will have ionic bonding. Similarly, then we talked about energy band diagram. Yeah, energy band gap. So energy forbidden energy band gap is nothing but the gap between insulator and valence electrons and conduction electrons, conduction band electrons. So the conduction band and valence band gap is nothing but called forbidden energy gap. Here also insulator have very high energy band gap, whereas conductor has no band gap between conduction and valence band, whereas semiconductor will have very less amount of gap of forbidden energy between conduction and valence band. So I hope you understand this concept. Thank you for today. In case of any queries or any doubt, you are most welcome to ask. Thank you.